Choice. Hope to see you again. Thank you. Oh, blast them.
Alec, whatever is the matter?
I have been intercepting nothing but poppycock propaganda about soothing syrup and whatnot. No, I swear to high heavens, if Starek's monopoly continues...
Alec, I beg your pardon. These are friends of mine. Evie Fry and her brother, Jacob.
Alexander Graham Bell.
Linguist, inventor, and technical expert. Alec, I have something of a favor to ask you.
Can you fix this?
Oh, looks like the casing is cracked. Oh! Comes apart. I see. Could have used one of these to fit my fuses on top of Big Ben.
Alec is installing a new telegraph line for our Free Press Association.
To combat the Starek Telegraph Company. Now, if I can mend the fuses connecting independent lines from Big Ben, Starek will be weakened. Only, we are somewhat at a handicap. And... there. Oh, I've removed the mechanism, so it may work with your bracer.
I'll put it to use immediately.
Jacob, wait. Mr. Bell, allow me to help you with your fuses.
Oh, you will not find me too proud to accept Miss Fry. Oh, we can use my carriage, if you'd be so good as to hold the reins, though.
I'll take that.
I can help you.
Oh, Miss Fry, I am so glad you could assist me.
Atta girl. So, Mr. Bell, what inventions are you concocting?
I intend to develop a phonetic telegraph that does not just convey dots and dashes, Miss Fry, but human voice.
Phonetic telegraph? Sounds a bit of a mouthful. You could just call it a telephone.
Telephone? How bizarre. Anyway, as I was saying earlier, the price has been highly dependent on the Static Telegraph Company.
Which is why Mr. Green has asked you to set up a free line.
Yes. What's more, other small independent companies have had their lines sabotaged, and they have little means of finding any broken fuses, which are...
to be found on top of Big Ben.
Correct.
They will not be a problem. I'll repair the fuses. Lovely view. That should do it.
Thank you very much, Miss Fry. I will now be able to continue with the installation of the new line.
If there's anything else I can do to help...
Certainly. Please do come and visit. I was toying with this device and have noted down the formula for you. It's not perfect yet, but by golly, it works.
all just attack on one
Pegasus?
Now what could that be?
What an arm!
Huh.
stop her! How about you?
I need your skills, lead on.
Please, I need help. Just a little generosity.
I have some work for you.
No need to ask twice.
After you.
They made me do it.
Agreed. Running only makes things worse. I'll cut you like a fist. I'll cut
your
tongue out.
Over there?
Oh, good lord. This should finish us off.
You suddenly need to be elsewhere.
Sword.
Shit!
Follow me.
I'm your man. should help you greatly.
Miss Fry,
I was just showing Jacob the first message was received via the mended lines. You can keep the rope launcher, by the way. We've managed to procure another one for your brother. Excellent work. Thank you again.
You're very welcome, Mr. Bell.
We can now defend the principle of impartial news and free speech.
Free is fair, but free and brief is far better.
Ha ha! Ah, Fry, such caustic wit.
And on that note, we must depart.
Good fortune to you both. Call on me at any time.
Now that we've finished with that distraction...
Who is that?
Oh, you mean... you don't know?
Beautiful train you got here. Miss McBean was just telling me all about her. Name's Ned.
How do you do?
I won't take up more of your time. If you want to learn a thing or two about the finest transit systems in the world, you can find me at this address.
Let us return to locating the Peace of Eden.
We need to reclaim London from Starrick. Who are my targets?
It's not time for that yet.
I didn't come to London to hunt curios.
First understand the dance, only then become the dancer.
Oh, so you're taking over where Father left off.
Someone has to.
Evie, finding the precursor artifact will give us an insight into what the Templars intend. Jacob, I have information about Starrick's associates that should be of use to you. Here.
This soothing syrup has become the only medicine available in Lambeth. It bears the Templar Grandmaster's name.
About time for a visit to the doctor.
I don't see that cure arriving anytime soon.
And what exactly will you be doing, might I ask?
You know very well. Tracking down the Peace of Eden.
Enjoy your studies. I'll be out killing Templars.
thought I'd stop by for a visit, my lord.
How's the old afternoon, Governor?
So, you give him a wink, give him a giggle, like friends.
Nothing like a good solid cane.
We need to do something about your outfit.
Another exciting night home for Evie Fry.
Just on my way out, actually. I found the Peace of Eden.
What's this one going to do, hmm? Heal the sick? Deflect bullets? Control the populace?
They're dangerous objects, Jacob, especially in Templar hands.
Oh, you sound exactly like Father.
If only. Lucy Thorne is expecting a shipment tonight. She's Starrick's expert in the occult. I'm nearly certain she is a piece of Eden, Sir David Brute.
Sounds like fun. Mind if I join you?
Promise you will stick to the mission.
I swear.
The contents of that box are worth more than your life and those of your entire family. Do you understand?
Yes, Miss Thorne.
Careful there! And double the guard on that cart!
Now, Miss Thorne, there's the matter of some papers for Mr. Starrick. If you'll just come this way.
Very well, but make it quick.
Whatever it is she's after, it's in that chest.
There are gunmen on the rooftops.
Can you dispose of them before I reach the cart?
I was hoping for a challenge.
Stop her!
Actually.
There he is!
I think it's best we leave.
What did you do?
It's hardly the time for questions!
Whoa! Come on!
It's all a commotion. Then where's your piece of Eden?
Get us out of this and I might find out!
Wait till you can't hit my sister!
Stop it!
Stay clear of.
Bad.
Come find up with something cold then!
What? We need to get this crate back to a safe place!
What do you think I'm trying to do?
At a desk? Okay, kill us, Boris!
Come find up with something cold then!
My sister has dodged bullets, too!
Fun. Thanks for the invitation.
Let's do it again.
Damn it.
The train for you. Lack of paint, new rugs from Camden Loch, and my wee sister, the seamstress, did a discount on the curtains.
Today, Evie.
Ah, solid okay. Good for putting a bit of stick about.
What an enjoyable day. What with Miss Thorne and the papers and all? Simply delightful. Something troubling you, Evie, old girl.
Thank you.